Today, I'm going to show you how to use the homemade biscuit mix recipe that I shared right here to make a Danish apple bar. We're going to be baking it in the RV's propane oven, and I have a couple of tricks on how to do that. Come on inside and we'll get started on the Danish apple bar. This is the propane oven in our Jayco travel trailer. The trailer is a 2008 and it's the oven that came in it. It is a Wedgwood Vision brand, and I don't really think there's a whole lot of difference between the different brands. I've done a lot of baking and cooking in propane. I also worked as a cook in camps where propane was the only way we had to cook. In most ovens in your home, you'll have a top element and a bottom element. In a propane oven, you only have a bottom element. There is no such thing as a top element in a propane oven. The thermostat itself is not very accurate. So the first thing I recommend you get is an oven thermometer, because this will give you an accurate reading of the temperature inside the oven. And you need to have it up here where the actual baking is going to be going on, not in the bottom of the oven where the flame is. The second thing I recommend you get is a pizza stone. And you can see mine here. Looks very dirty, but it works really, really well. This one is made by Pampered Chef, and it is, as you can see, a rectangular size, and it fits perfectly into my RV oven. It just slides right in there. And it leaves a little bit of room at the front and a little room at the back so that the heat can circulate better. You can also use a round one or whatever else you can find. The thicker the better, because that will disperse the heat better and not make it such a direct heat on the bottom of whatever you're cooking in here. When you're baking something in a propane oven and you don't want the bottom to brown too quickly, you can also add a layer of tin foil with the shiny side facing away from the food, and it will reflect more of the heat so the bottom of your food won't brown too quickly. Things will brown on the top because the heat circulates. We're gonna see that when we bake this Danish apple bar. So now I'm going to fire it up. I'm going to be turning the temperature up to 400 degrees on the thermostat, but we're going to be taking what's on this oven thermometer to be the truth. My oven is about 50 degrees off, so I'm going to be setting this to 400 degrees, but I'm probably going to be turning it down to around 350. One of the things that I had a hard time finding when I was outfitting the RV kitchen a few years ago was a cookie sheet that would actually fit into that small oven. Most of them were too big, and when I finally found one I thought would work, I brought it home and it was just slightly too big. So what did I do? I got a pair of pliers and bent it. See how I bent this edge up? One of the things that I find really handy to have in the RV for baking is parchment paper. This one, you can see it's well traveled. This stuff is indispensable. When you're trying to conserve water and wash as few dishes as you can, this stuff really saves on cleanup. I'm getting the pan ready before I start mixing up the ingredients. I'm going to spray a little bit of cooking spray on the pan before I put the parchment paper on it. The cooking spray holds the parchment paper in place so it doesn't slip around. So the pan is all ready, paper's not falling out, and we're good to start mixing stuff up. The first thing we're going to need is the biscuit mix that I mixed up in a previous video and baked biscuits on the cooktop in a cast iron frying pan. If you go to this video right here, it'll show you how to make this mix. We're also going to be needing some sugar. In the RV, I use an empty syrup bottle to keep our sugar in, because you can pour out as much as you need into your coffee. You can take the lid out to measure a bigger amount. We're also going to need some cinnamon, some vanilla, some apples, some icing sugar. I use large freezer Ziploc bags to keep things like icing sugar in. They take up a lot less room and you can stack them into a basket in the cupboard. We're also going to need an egg and some milk, which are in the fridge. Now I'll show you what to do with all this stuff. So we have our bowl here. We're going to measure in 2 cups of our biscuit mix. Half a cup. Gracie, get out of there. Gracie, shoo. She doesn't have very good manners. Gracie, she smells the milk. Half a cup of milk. So that was 1/4 cup. Here's another 1/4 cup. Half a cup. We're going to separate 1 egg and put the yolk into the biscuit mix. So here we have our egg white and we've got the yolk in the biscuit mix. We're going to set aside the egg white because we're going to be using that later. We are also going to add to our basic biscuit mix a couple of tablespoons of sugar. Now this is a personal choice. If you do not like things too sweet, then you can leave the sugar out. Then we're just going to mix it up. And when all the floury particles are moist, we're going to form it into a ball. Now, because this bar has a top and a bottom crust, we're going to divide this ball of dough in half. So I'm going to use the one half and set aside the other half. So now we've got our dough on our parchment paper lined cookie sheet, and we're going to press it out. The dough will be a little wetter than the biscuit dough recipe, so we're putting a little bit of flour on the top so it doesn't stick. So we can press that out, and we're going to be covering the whole bottom of the cookie sheet with this dough. So I have this very handy little rolling pin that I got from Pampered Chef, and I use that in the trailer because I don't need a full-size rolling pin in here. It's nice because it fits inside the pan. So I'm just going to roll this out so it covers the entire bottom of the pan. I'm also holding the parchment paper down so it doesn't shift. Add more flour if you need to. If you need to do any patching, if you've torn it open anywhere, just pat it into place. It doesn't matter what it looks like. Okay, so the whole bottom of our pan is covered now. It's a little thin there. It doesn't need to go up the sides. Now we're going to deal with the apples. I don't bother to peel the apples. I just core them and then I slice them up onto the dough. These are last year's apples from the orchards around us. So you want to pile the apples up, but you want to keep them away from about half an inch around the edge. For this size pan, it's taking 3 normal sized apples. If you are using a larger pan, you might need to use 4 apples, and you might also need to adjust the amount of dough. It might take, instead of the 2 cups that we used for this one, you might want to use 3 cups, and then you would need to adjust the rest of the ingredients. So instead of it being half a cup of milk, it would be 3/4 cups of milk and maybe 3 tablespoons of sugar. You could still just put in the 1 egg though. So I'm just going to adjust the apples here so they are all away from the edge and fairly evenly covered. There's the apples all sliced up on the bottom crust of our bar. Now I'm going to add some cinnamon, and I'm just going to sprinkle that on the top. If you like lots of cinnamon, put lots on. And some sugar. Depending on how sweet a tooth you have, you can put more on or less. And then I'm just going to set it aside while we work on the other crust. This clip seems to have disappeared. To roll out the top crust, I use a flexible cutting board and lots of flour to keep the dough moving around on the board. Roll out the dough to the size that will cover the entire pan. You can hold the flexible cutting board over the pan to see if it's big enough. When you've rolled it to the right size, so now I'm checking the size to make sure it's going to cover everything, and it looks pretty good. So what we're going to do is, we get kind of tricky here, we're going to take this cutting mat with the dough on the top and we're going to flip it upside down. In a perfect world, this clip would not have messed up. If you have allowed your bottom crust to move around on the cutting board as you rolled it out, you will be able to lift the board off the dough, leaving the dough covering your bottom layer. Ta-da! We're going to use the egg whites from the other half of the egg, and we're going to seal the edges up using the pastry brush to brush it on. We're just going to peel back the edge a little bit and brush the egg whites on there, fold it back and press it down, and just go all the way around. The extra dough here, you can either cut it off, but I just fold it in. Now we once again take our egg wash, we brush it over the entire surface of the bar. When we take this out of the oven, we're going to be making up a little bit of a drizzle icing to go on the top. If you don't have a sweet tooth and you just want a little bit of sweetness, you can sprinkle a little bit of sugar over the top. It depends on what you want to do with it afterwards. But I'm going to be doing the icing, so I'm just going to leave it plain. So now this is going to go into the oven. .400 degrees, perfect. Now my thermostat, I adjusted down because it was getting too hot, and it's now set at just above 350. So my oven is about 50 degrees off from the thermostat to the thermometer that I have in the oven. I think I deserve a coffee now. It's too bad YouTube doesn't have smell-o-vision, because it is smelling so good in here. While the Danish apple bar is finishing up baking, we're going to make the icing for it. Need about a half a cup of icing sugar, and I'm just going to put it in this cup and try not to get it all over the counter. About a half a teaspoon of vanilla, and a couple of teaspoons of water. You can use milk too if you like. We're going to stir it up. They're ready. Do you want to see? Now we're going to put on the icing. There it is. You can see how nice and evenly it browned in the oven, and that's with just the heat from the bottom of the oven with a pizza stone underneath the pan. So now, while it's still warm, we're going to drizzle the icing over top. So let's cut this puppy up. I'm going to try and flip it over without destroying it. Just right. If you have some ice cream, you can put that on the top, or maybe some whipping cream, but it's also delicious all by itself. Well, maybe with the addition of a cup of coffee, that would be perfect. Yep, it's delicious.